I think we had just finished dealing with the demon. I remember we fought Spider Lady. Spider Lady was scary, and I got a little tilted. And then we had the demon. We had, oh, shit. Was it Sword Breaker? Was that... It was Something Breaker, right? Oh, I don't want Japanese. I want to change that back. What's up, Wolf? How you doing today? Hope you're doing well. I apologize. Again, I'm feeling just really out of it. I don't know if it's like... If it's the weather or what. Just I'm like... I'm feeling so out of it. Can I not choose language? What? What? You're kidding me. Really? Huh. If I head back to the... Can I quit? How do I do this? How does this work? Okay, well, never mind, I guess. We'll just... Does that explain what's wrong? I accidentally chose the Japanese voices. That's fine. What? We'll live with it this time. Fried meat of a bird that lives near rocky shores, said to bear the spirits of ill-fated sailors. I don't know who's talking. Oh, this is gonna be so confusing. We'll see how this goes. Right, so I think we were over there last time, and then we went further on, and then that's how we got to the sword breaker. So we haven't been down here. Let's go down here. Oh, there's a warp point. Oh, well, that's nice, I guess. It'll give you the option each time you boot up. Right. I wasn't sure if I could change that from like a menu outside of like just starting up the game though, you know? Oh well. Or I can just get straight up money. Stop it. Stop. Uh-oh. Never mind. Weakness is to earth. What do we have that's earth? Oh, well, we could just bring Aizen out, right? You're earth. You're also earth. Okay, so why B? Wait, what? Oh, right. I start with less because we got surprised. Yeah. Can you please stop? Am I ready to read some subtitles? I'm always ready. Like, I will almost exclusively read subtitles, if I'm being honest. It is... So, like, I don't know how to explain it. It's very difficult for me to, like, process things only by listening to them. So, I will almost always need subtitles in order to, like, maintain full attention and, like, catch stuff. Because I can read way faster than I listen to it. And, like, I read way better than anything else.
Oh,
Oh, whoops. I still want a plush of them. Whatever these are. Ow. Oh, pug. Alright, I can't do it. I can't do it. We are rebooting. Can I? No, I can't. Soft reset. I don't know if that's the little thing here. Is there a way for me just to leave, or do I just need, like, exit? Even if I load, I can't just, like... Ooh. Rough. Strategy so far in this game has been to go on a rampage and use attacks with long stagger to try and help my allies chain their attacks in. That makes sense, right? Like, that absolutely makes sense. Aldo, what's up, Al? How's your day going? English this time. Cool.
Oh my gosh.
Man, I've got like the... I have such a... Oh, hello, Trent. I have like... one of the worst just like headaches going on over this past like week and a half. I finished Inside Job. That was the anime show we were talking about the other day, right? About the Illuminati lizard folks. Enjoy it? Did it end well? Alright, nothing back there. Cool. Anything down here? No? Okay. So we go climb. It was a hell of an ending. Oh no. Did it set up a future season? Or is it kind of like a one and done deal? Hello, Rock. Very interested in season 2. Okay. Well, that answers my question. That answers my question. Oh, well, we can go get the kitty cat chest.
Oh my gosh.
I apologize for all the yawning. Got a drop earring. What does that mean? Okay. That should be fine. Sure. Oh, I can go over here. From a stream where the streamer was talking about the show and whole chat, I was talking about the documentary of the same name. What happens on September involving a couple town? Oh, I guess that would make sense. Yeah, I think I still haven't gone back to it. And I'm really kicking myself for this. I keep meaning to go back to the Bob Ross, one of the new Bob Ross documentaries that came out. I just haven't had the time for it.
Now why does that name sound so familiar?
They make a jet fuel can't melt anything jokes in the show. Why am I not surprised?
Eleanor? Thanks for stepping in earlier.
Think nothing of it. My orders are to protect you, so I did.
Oh, I see.
Of course, orders or no orders, I'd save anyone under threat from a demon.
Well, how noble.
Oh, I got it!
Got what?
The tragic tale of the Sword Stormquill! Gather round and listen, oh grimy travelers! Once, centuries past, there was a sword renowned the world over for its peerlessly sharp edge, its forger shrouded in mystery. So mighty was each swing of the sword, it produced howling winds that could level mountains! No other sword could match its power. The people, in their superstition, began to call it the Godblade!
This Godblade... is it Stormquill?
Shush! The tale is merely beginning. Now, there was one man who was truly enamored with the Godblade. His name was Kurogane, a blacksmith of wondrous talent.
Have we heard that name yet?
Set on forging an even greater sword.
And I remember.
He had a name in mind for this sword. Stormquell, the sword to conquer the Godblade's roaring winds.
And did he make it?
Kurogane forged scores of challengers to the Godblade. But each would-be Stormquell was shattered by the implacable howling wind. Some say the wielder of the Godblade chopped off his head. Others say he took his own life. The truth is lost to the dusty cobwebs of history. But perhaps he, and his grudge towards the Godblade, somehow yet live.
A grudge that spans centuries.
You hear tall tales like this all the time. That sword and its inscription we saw were probably just inspired by the legend.
Perhaps. But if that's the real Stormquell, we should all sleep with one eye open tonight.
Kurogane means iron?
Because that Godblade Kurogane wanted so desperately to top has been passed down through my family for generations. Its name is Stormhowl.
In other words, we could well bump into your armored friend again. Let's hurry it up.
That is a good question. Let's see. Kurogane. Black steel. I guess it's also part of the Super Robot Wars series? Fictional ship? Okay. Well, that answers that for me. Ooh. This is pretty. I like all the, am I to assume this is ore? These are crystals? That is a lamp. I guess let's go down here, because there's got to be something down here. No, wait, other end. Wait, no, we were there. Wait, what? How am I getting... I'm like five steps in. How am I getting lost? Cool, we got some zombies. Yeah, so... Kira was like the only... One of the only... words I'm familiar with. Just interesting, because like one of the first
you can't trust her just because she said she'd protect you.
Not first, what?
No orders. Remember,
one of the big like happy hardcore Nightcore DJs I used to listen to was Kiro.
Really did protect me.
I know, so that always just stuck with me.
But do you have to look so happy about it?
Sorry.
I'm not asking for an apology. I just want her to know that we've all got an eye on her. No matter how close you two get, I want her to understand that I come first.
So, what do you want me to do?
Let's see. To put it simply, I'm number one, and Eleanor is number two. Got it?
I get it. You're number one, and Eleanor is number two.
Right. I'm number one. Wait, this is kind of stupid, isn't it?
It's all right. I understand.
That's not what I mean.
I think it's funny that we're telling number two that we are number one. Excuse me, number one. What the hell are you?
I won't run away.
Oh. Okay. What are you weak to? You're weak to wind. Do we have any winds? Oh, we do have winds. This is not going well. I'm sorry. Hey, I'm not getting much back at all. There we go. Yeah, you do well to figure out which side of them is the front. Yeah. Yeah. That is... Ooh, that's fair. Ah, ha, 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 we have... Oh, Taco's down. One point one two. Well, take that, sure. So now the question of, do we take on Code Red? Like, in what world do I not? Oh, I can't. I can see it, but I can't take it on yet. Okay. Well, we'll go save. What are you?
A candle? What's that doing here?
Oh! I think these were used to keep robbers away, like wards around old king's tombs. I've read about this. There's a trick to the stone. It reacts to heat.
Heat, huh?
Huh.
Then there's only one thing to do.
Some doors are sealed with a flame enchantment and cannot be opened by ordinary means, but by finding and lighting candles in the area, you can dispel the enchantment and open the door. You may have to light more than one candle to open some doors. Okay. So this is essentially our flame in the exterior. Okay, got it. Oh, is that the same emblem? Kind of looked like it. Huh. Don't really have a face, so that makes it trickier, but the geometry is different on both sides. Right, I mean, it looked like the, like, crystallized arm was the right arm, yeah? Oh, hello. Uh-oh. There's no way that sounds well. Yeah, I'll take 1200 gold. Sure, don't twist my arm about it.
Oh my gosh.
I'm so sorry for all the yawning. Like I said, I've been, like, so under the weather. Hi, snake lady.
Are we ready for this?
I'll stop you.
Resistance is the fire, so we want Earth to come out. And you're resistant. Okay, so we want you to have Earth. Everything else is whatever. Got it.
Oh,
Alright. Not too bad. Wait, is that everything? It is. Alright, cool. Do we have... Nepatius? No. Hey, we got some masteries, though. Cool. Doubles the effect rate for the first strike combat. Ooh. Okay, neat. They don't tend to be completely above ground. You actually pass one in the room before the last. Oh. Well, I kind of don't want to run into anything. I mean, whatever. That's fine. Let's get equipment. Oh, you're so close. Do I have any other boots for you? I mean... I guess. Everything else is mastery except for... Alright, cool. Alright, so Wind Ring is good on you. The Aqua Ring. Fire Ring, Void Ring. Doesn't sound bad. We'll do that, sure. Yeah, that doesn't sound like a bad idea for you. And you only have the ribbon. Alright, cool. Good to go. Velv uses her demon powers to see. Wait, what? I certainly missed something. So I assume that, like, the two there are the... Oops. Are our rock friendos.
Oh my god.
I don't like the sounds they make, man. About rise are covered by the cowboy hat. Gotcha. Gotcha, yeah, it's the demon sense. That's what... It's the Toidles! That's what's going on. I still feel like the cowboy has, like, one of the best calls I've ever made. I don't know, I feel like it's really fit Velvet's personality. Ooh, we can get a new spear. Okay, 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 okay. Plus 30% attack when HP is 8% or lower. Okay, 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 okay. Fatiguing capability. Oh, that's a status, right? Okay. I think I'm gonna go with you, to be honest. Honestly, that's all really good. Sure. Oh, we don't have a whole lot of money. What am I saying? We have 21k. No, I'm looking at the wrong spot. Okay. We're fine. Go pick that up. Go pick that up. Heart attack, HP cover, and defeating foes. He doesn't have that. Okay. Go with it. We got the belts. Absorb HP. Wait, is it the same? Oh, it's a Kelsey garment. Oh. Well, do I with that? Wait. Okay. Wait. That absorb HP. 1.15. Does that turn into 1.3? Because they stack together? Only one? Oh, it's saying that I have three owned. Wait, it's saying I have three owned? That can't be. Not three of those. No, it's just three calcite garments. In general? Oh, good God. I don't know how to read stats. I'll get one. Got none of these, I'll get one. Effective slow reduced by 40%. I would love to have that. Slow is so annoying. Effective burn reduced by 40%. We have, what, three of these? We're fine. Do I want two? No, I feel like I only want the one. And boots. I would love to get some new boots for folks. Do I dare get two of those? I can only get one. Yeah, I guess that'll be it. Silky touch garments. Okay. Oh, time to do... Oh, that's so close. Time to do some more. Oh, I like the way that looks. I like the way that looks. That looks like a key. Oh my gosh. That eagle looks like it's anamorphin. Oh, that's funny. It's not mastered. And I want the damage reduced by 5%. Okay. All right. Well, I think we're probably good for now. Okay, cool. That don't sound good. Oh? Who are you? Mentor? Teacher?
No.
Well, if you aren't the craziest demon, your body's harder than your own sword.
Brother?
Who's this? That's Lord Shigure, one of the only two legate exorcists in the entire abbey.
A legate? Same as Melchior.
And this is who Roku's been trying to find, right?
Eleanor, fancy meeting you here. What the hell happened to you? You get captured by a demon? Or are you a turncoat?
I'm...
Long story.
Don't matter. I do my own thing. I got no standing to tell you how to live. Still, today's my lucky day. Never thought I'd encounter the one and only Stormquell.
Shigure, I think someone over there wants your attention. He looks lonely.
You're right, I'm being a jerk. Just can't pass up the chance to tease my little brother. Can I, Rokuro?
Your brother?
You haven't changed a bit, Shigure.
Who saw that coming?
Dumbass, I'm bucket load stronger now.
Surely not me.
Who hasn't changed, I bet. You still hung up on trying to take me down?
The one you want to beat in a fight? That's him?
I'm not who I was that day either. brother.
Oh.
Is this Tokyo Ghoul?
You're a demon? Now it's getting good. But I wonder, has that really changed anything?
Uh-oh.
When my real storm howl breaks your sad reject again, you gonna piss yourself like last time?
Jesus.
I'll handle him.
No.
No matter what, I need you to stay out of it.
No.
All right.
Don't be an idiot. And we're playing. Uh-oh.
It's been too long since we crossed swords, brother.
You're dead. I'll make you regret sparing.
I don't like this. I'm sorry. Oh my god. Okay. I get it. Keep doing that 1,000 times. Never mind. Wait, so we have lowered attack, we've increased. What? Oh! I didn't realize I could issue commands like that. Oh, that's neat. Yeah, haha! Glad I take you. Who the shutter down? Oh my god. Uh-oh. Yeah. Yeah, okay. I have to win. Oh, fuck. Okay. Well, shit.
It's been too long since swords, brother.
How am I half health?
You're dead. I'll make you regret sparing my life last time.
Why am I half health? Oi. Well, I appreciate the encouragement. Do I need to hold it? Not entirely sure how is this supposed to work. I should probably read it. That would be helpful. Oh, hold on. We're catching you. We're getting these. That's fine. I was blocking, but okay. God damn it. Got it. Okay. Man, I'm not getting these. Time needs to line up. I'm behind you, my guy. Right, can't activate because it's a counter. That's fine. We got the... Oh, if we do the blast gauge when we're... Ooh, if he's stunned, though. Wait, really? That was... Early? That's it? That's it. Okay. Okay, whatever. This is art. Not gonna lie, like, I'm a sucker.
Alas, I think our fight's over.
What?
Oh no. Oh no.
I said stay out of this! We're just getting started.
Oh. No backing down for you this time.
Oh. Are we supposed to know that the sword was broken?
But we're done for today.
I didn't remember that.
Oh, calm down, Rokuro.
I definitely don't remember that.
We could have a real fight sometime if you actually brought a decent sword. Go ask that old bastard there to make you one. I'll be waiting.
Huh? Who?
That demon in the armor, Kuragane.
The blacksmith from the story.
Huh.
I'll be waiting for you at Fort Cadnix. Unless you can beat me, you ain't getting off this island.
Who are you to decide that?
You got a problem with it, lady?
I mean, I had you. Almost.
Best of luck, you demons.
Kinda.
You'll need it.
Lord Shigure, sir. I'm on a high-level mission.
Eleanor, babe, I get it. You've gone rogue. Have fun with that. I see you again. I'll kill you.
Okay. I guess.
He wasn't even trying yet.
How would Abby respond to that if Kirigane killed Eleanor?
That won't work. But there is another way.
What are you talking about? What way?
Follow me.
Are we gonna reforge the blade? Ooh. Rokuro's battle bill. Oh, now we learn about them.
Velvet,
now we learn about them.
This is his fight. It has nothing to do with me.
But Shigure said he'd be waiting at the port. He may be a nutball, but I don't think he's fool enough to let us slip past.
Exactly. And as a swordsman, he's even more skilled than Artorias, and that's saying something.
We're mice with our tails pinned, and the cat's licking his lips.
At the very least, Kuragane seems to have some kind of plan.
Fine. We'll hear what he has to say.
Won't respond well if Luffy turns to a demon. Fair.
What was that fat cat creature with Shigure?
You mean Morgrim? She's a Moloch. She just looks different.
And?
And what? She has all the abilities of a Moloch. I'm not trying to keep anything from you. All I know is her name and that she's a Moloch.
This is like our dog friend from Zestiria, right?
Shigure is an exorcist legate, but he's also a warrior who can match exorcists or demons even without the use of Moloch arts. Since no one has ever seen Shigure use an art, Morgrim is considered one of the Seven Wonders of the Abbey.
The Seven Wonders of the Abbey!
No one knows Morgrim's capabilities, or even the details of Shigure's pact with her.
No one! Except me, that is!
Huh?
This is all highly classified, but Morgrim is incredibly lazy. The price she demanded of Shigure for making a pact with her was grooming and defleeing.
Anything else?
Oh, and on a point of sensitivity, she's chubby, not fat. She may be our enemy, but she's also a woman. You should try not to hurt each other's feelings.
Anything else?
Her thick eyebrows are all the rage with Malakim, so much so that false eyebrows are expected to be the next big thing.
Well, if he's that strong without Moloch arts, I don't want to see what he's like with them.
Hmm. Reminds me of Kenpachi from Bleach. Right, like Kenpachi's whole deal is that doesn't summon the use of his Bankai? That's what's called, right? The spirit within the weapons. But like he doesn't use his the soul power? Yeah, it's been so long since I've kept up with Bleach. Well, that's definitely what, Shogane reminds me of. Oh, our ship's back. We got fake food. Aight. A painting salvaged from a wreck drifting in the Astra Sea. This landscape depicts a tower of rebirth and a castle in the sky. The pair of pair symbolic of unity between heaven and earth. Neat. Is Shikai? Is that what it is? Shikai? Because from what I remember, like his ability to like. Not detect, but like use his soul energy sort of in space. That's the base one. Okay.
We can't best Shigure without a strategy. We should ask.
Yeah, Lord knows. Like I said, it's been ages and ages and ages and ages. I don't think I've kept up with Bleach to like a few years after high school. Sword is in the base form. Right, so is it always- it's- okay. Yeah. That's sounding more right.
What were you thinking, Eleanor? Attacking a legate like that?
Well...
So he uses no fancy tricks, just force, and I respect it.
I was going to die if I didn't intervene.
Oh? You'd kill one of your own allies for a demon?
I acted without thinking. Sometimes I'm too soft-hearted to a fault.
I'd say it's less that, and more just stupidity. You're supposed to be protecting Lafayette. Don't get yourself into trouble you don't need.
Even if one of our own is in danger?
Even then.
Especially then.
This kid must be really important to her. All right, I understand.
Lafayette, next time she acts up, stop her. Understand? We don't know what she's got up her sleeve.
Okay.
What's
Thanks
it?
For not telling on me, Eleanor. And I'm sorry I hijacked your body.
I understand how it feels to want to protect your friends. The problem's with those demons, not you.
But I think Velvet has the capacity to feel the same way, too. At least when it comes to her brother.
Is that why you're staying with her?
I'm not sure. It's hard to say.
I have to figure out what's going on with this group, if I ever hope to wrest the child from them.
Okay. So Ichika's sword was a katana before it got stuck, in its, Shikai permanently. So, would that have... would that have been... during the events of his soul tethering? Oh, it big. That's what it's called, right? The tethering when they're trying to break the chain? Over at, Green Hat Dudes. Oh god, I don't remember his name. One of my favorite characters, I don't remember his name. Green Hat Dude's house. Because from there, he meets... the actual... sword, and then after the I might be misremembering. I think Hope and I started up Bleach. Oh no, that's not true. Yeah, Hope and I started up Bleach like 2 years ago. I got to like the first three seasons. I think we got after like rescuing Rukia, and then we got up to the return. The Soul Society? I don't know, I also have the memory of a goldfish, so... I can't say anything. The moment he starts using sword beams, he's already transformed it. Shit, I remember sword beams. All this is like the earth, like, splitting stuff. Which I believe that would ring a bell. Like he's like swings down, splits the earth. Is that water? No, that's no. We need to fly. plane where Ichigo lacks basic control. I think it's funny because it feels like that is every... It feels like that's every shonen series ever. What's done here? Not worth it. Getsu Gatensho? I have no idea what that is. That does not sound familiar at all. I mean, like, I get why, right? Like, it's adversity. You're gonna have your protagonist struggle, and they're gonna go through, like, a whole big learning arc. But, like, it is always, literally always, the basics. You struggle with the basics. Although, I guess, like, does Hajime count as a shonen series? Hajime no Ippo? Because it felt like Hajime was like...
Look at all those swords.
Dunking on dudes left and right since the very start.
That's what happens when the legendary blacksmith Kurogane toils so hard he forgets to die.
I gave up everything, thinking of nothing else but forging a sword that could surpass Storm Howl. And before I knew it...
You had traded your humanity for demonhood.
I see I'm not the only one. So great was your grudge against your brother, the inheritor of Storm Howl.
Well, guess we're not so different. You don't suppose you could hammer me up a new sword, do you?
I've forged countless blades over these long years, yet not one has proven a match for Storm Howl. And yet you still seek a Kurogane sword?
I'll put it like this. No matter how much you've failed across the centuries, you've never broken. Well, I'm the same way. If anything can break Shigure and his god blade, it's the bitterness I carry.
Yeah, you tell him, Patch Man.
Strangely enough, seeing you and your brother has given me an idea that might work. I will forge you a new blade.
Should we get some Brightstone?
Nope. No need for that. Should I take it from the top?
If you would. My arms are all I'll be needing.
Okay.
What are you doing?
Don't be alarmed. I'm just cutting free some raw materials for the sword.
Okay.
You see something new every day.
Okay.
You need his head to make the sword?
That's right. With this fine clump of pure resentment, I shall forge your imitation Storm Howl anew.
No. I only keep this imitation as a reminder of how weak-willed I was in the past. To defeat Shigure, I've perfected the art of dual-wielding. A secret Rangetsu technique.
All right. If that's what you prefer, a pair of short swords it is.
I'm here for it. Huh. Getsuga Tensho is Ichigo's most basic special move. Doesn't use too much else. It's just a long-range sword attack made of spiritual pressure. Glows blue. Until Bankai when it turns into black. Oh my god. I feel so bad for not remembering that at all. These swords will be ahead of bump the rest. God damn it. God damn it. Oh, God. You think when it's done, there'll be a weight off his shoulders?
The ship is on its way, right on schedule.
Of course it is. They don't have the Reaper on board.
One more thing. Apparently, Shigure is Artorias' bodyguard.
So we'll have to face him down sometime, no matter what.
It's in our best interest to get rid of him while he's working alone. The problem is, Rokuro can't beat him by himself.
Agreed. Shigure is not to be trifled with.
Certainly. That's why, when Rokuro creates an opening, we're going to take Shigure out.
You want us to meddle in somebody else's private quarrel?
If it affects my own quarrel, yes.
I suppose I'm in the same position. Besides, I can still use him. There's no sense in throwing his life away.
Rokuro's not really a guy to care about the big picture. He might try to hack your limbs off a bit, but he'll get over it.
I made the Enfu rush out to the docks to scout the place out. Pretty smart, am I right?
I pity that creature sometimes.
All the time.
That Kudogane, though. What a character. Giving his own body to forge a sword. Like some kind of ritual sacrifice.
Ritual sacrifice. It's certainly something only a demon would do. It was a necessary sacrifice in order to gain power.
A necessary sacrifice. What a vicious turn of phrase.
Indeed.
Still, I can't say I'm not thrilled to see how it all turns out. If what you give is mere meat for a god's morbid lunch, could there be a more trivial sacrifice? But if the offering is one's own body and soul, even a single hair can be portentous. I wonder which he will have been in the end.
Some interesting musing from our witch friend. Huh. Still, I can't really tell, like, where she lies. Clearly, like, still self-interested, but...
Rokuro, Kudogane, I just do not understand them. You saw them. Demons. We're crazy, sure. But they go through life with such crystal clear sense of purpose. Even demons have things they're not willing to let go. Or do you think us mere animals, running around killing people left and right?
I know, I know. I understand demons still have a certain consciousness, but I look at those two, and they seem passionate, like normal people.
Well, I've yet to meet a human so passionate he'd chop his own head off.
Do you have a purpose like they do?
I do, in fact. Ever since Artorias used my brother as a sacrifice.
Typical demon nonsense. The Abbey exists to protect the people. Yes, sometimes cold, painful decisions need to be made to protect the many. But they'd never stoop to human sacrifice. Besides, as shepherd, Artorias will cleanse the world of...
If that's what you think, ask the precious shepherd yourself. Ask him just what he did 3 years ago.
He wouldn't. He'd never.
3 years ago, 10 years ago, same thing. I'm still convinced that, like, somehow Selica was used for something. We haven't really gotten any confirmation on that yet, though. We don't really know a whole lot about, like, what... really happened to Selica.
Rokuro wants to slay his brother, even if it kills him. And Kurogane had his own head lopped off just to forge powerful swords. How do those two find it in themselves to go so far?
It's just how they are. They're demons. Not exactly normal.
Yeah, it's scary. But I also kinda admire it. But me, I don't have anything I'm that desperate to accomplish.
Not yet, you mean. In time, you'll find something.
You really think so?
Almost certainly. But don't feel you have to go and risk your life over it. You're not a demon. And you should stay that way. You deserve a normal life.
Live a normal life, my guy.
But never mind. Just the foolish ramblings of a demon girl.
Bad, bad news! A group of praetors have left the docks and are headed this way! They said they were coming to purge Eleanor the traitor!
Why?
Velvet, what do we do?
We take them head on.
This... how?
And you're fighting
why?
With us, Eleanor.
An order, I presume.
It is. Protect Lafayette. And defeat the exorcists.
All right. I understand.
Just remember, if we lose Eleanor, Lafayette will turn into a demon.
I haven't forgotten. But we need to pool all the resources we have. She needs us for her own ends. And we'll use that to our advantage in this fight.
Just don't push your luck too far, Velvet.
And so recently was she a noble, upstanding young exorcist. How quickly one falls when entering Velvet's dark orbit.
Ask me if I care.
So, you would think that it would be in the Abbey's best interest to not have their own people murder Eleanor, thereby murdering Lafayette, right? one would think. That makes sense. So I guess one has to assume that they haven't gotten the word out this far yet. And that's why all this is going on. Keep getting Celica and Sarah's mixed up. Kind of convinced they were the same character, but I guess that doesn't make sense. I mean, Sarah's was the... was Artorias' Malakim, right? Unless that would mean that Velvet was also Malakim? I don't know. But also, like, so I guess that brings up an interesting point, actually. Am I going backwards? I might be going backwards. Arthur could see Cirrus, meaning that he already had like a high resonance count, value, whatever you want to call it. So him being Shepherd lines up with what we know, yeah? Because not everyone, I mean, at least until what, the incident three years ago, Malakim were very difficult to see, and only those with high resonance were able to. I had this in my head before I knew what were Malaks. What, confusing Cirrus and Celica? So we're just supposed to leave, right? Ah. Got it. Now to find these invading exorcists. There's a cutscene that seems to suggest Velvet might have been able to see Cirrus. But isn't stated in the beginning that she can't? Are we to presume that we're only seeing from Laffy's view in that cutscene? Okay. If we've already passed it, I certainly didn't take it that way.
Praetor Eleanor, you should be ashamed of yourself. Cowering to demons.
Your collusion could spell disaster to the Abbey if left unchecked. The only possible atonement is your death.
Ow. Oh no! Alright, so that's used to juggle. Got it. Ow! Rude. All right, well, cool. Good to know that Velvet died. That's fantastic. Thank you. Can you, like, not do that, please? God damn it. Stay still. Wait, that hit? Why that hit? What? Shit. Glad to take it. No, you fool! No! Oh god, no. Leave me alone. Stop it, stop it, stop it, stop it, stop it. Thank you. Leave me alone. Stop it, stop it, stop it, stop it. Thank you. Oh, never mind. Okay. Thank you, game. Thank you for holding my hands. I appreciate it.
You've betrayed the people and sullied Artorias' ideals.
No, that's not...
What if it's... Wait. The moment when Velvet eats Cirrus?
Velvet.
At that point, she should see Cirrus.
I know I have to fight. My mission calls for it.
Right?
But any more of this will kill
Unless
them.
We're getting a flashback from her.
Time for you to die and
that might be
hurt.
What I'm thinking of.
Eleanor!
And you're saying that that's from Cirrus' point of view?
I can't do it. I can't kill them.
I'm not done yet.
All right.
There. Now we're even, Eleanor.
You've got new swords.
Look at
Sinister.
That.
I like it.
I take it you're ready.
Yeah. All that's left is to kill Shigure.
Let's go fuck some shit up.
With me as a witness.
I
keep on fighting like that, and you'll be killed. And if you get killed, Luffy said we'll lose his vessel.
I know that.
Velvet, wait.
You're not going to kill them?
I'm just not that hungry right now. I've got new orders for you. Fight the exorcists, but make sure they don't die.
Understood.
Okay.
I guess that was as far as Eleanor could go.
I think so. Push her any further and she's bound to break.
Ever the virtuous exorcist.
That very virtue is what lets her be Lafayette's vessel. Besides, I can't help but admire her commitment. She's enduring total disgrace to accomplish her mission.
How uncommonly pleasant of you.
Pleasant folks don't use people the way we do.
Yeah, you've got that right.
Always be on guard.
I like the way that Aizen and Velvet bonds. Wow.
Welp, that about does it.
Well, that worked. Glad to take that. Hey, we got a new pendant. Neat. Earth attack power plus 4%. Eh. Art attack, eh. Those will probably be our next call. Nope, everyone's all good to go. Okay, cool.
Hey, Bienfu. I was wondering if I could talk to you about something that's on my mind.
I figured it was just about the time that you and I had the talk, actually. I've seen it all, heard it all, and even tasted it all in my time as a Moloch. Ask me anything you want.
Thanks. I was... was hoping you could let me borrow those books you were reading earlier, if that's okay.
You mean how to talk a human female into becoming your vessel, and how to get the cuties?
Hey, keep it down, keep it down.
But you and Madame Eleanor have already formed a pact. Why do you still need either of those books?
Well, it's like when we're alone together, things get so awkward. It's hard to talk with her, you know?
That happens a lot with Molochemon vessels who are still new to the whole thing. I've been there. In that case, I've got an even better book for you.
Don't look like that.
You read a lot of books.
I don't like those eyes.
I'm just an avid learner,
I don't trust those eyes.
Now let's see. Oh, here we go. Hot spring topics. Bearing your body and your soul. Being upfront and honest is always the best policy.
I don't think we'll be bathing in any hot springs together. Do you have anything else?
All right, then how about after bath party games, dropping your defenses and your towels?
Why do you keep trying
Why
to get
Why does this
naked?
Exist?
I think that would just make things even more awkward.
Picky. Tell you what, you can just look at my collection and pick whatever sounds good.
Love hacking, living long and loving hard, diary of a diary thief, hands speak louder than words.
Oh my god.
All classics. Jesus. I remember reading them when Miss Moggy Lou and I were struggling to get along. Oh, to be young again.
You ever think maybe things would have been easier if you never read these books?
Reading the mood, knowing what to say and how to say it. That one's a winner, a must read for sure.
Are you two reading something together?
We are. Lafayette's been worried about that awkward distance between you two, and he came to me for some advice. I've heard his side of the story, so let's you and I grab some tea and talk about what to do about it. Come on, let's go.
Oh, okay.
Knowing what to say and how to say it. I don't think this will help either.
God, I worry for Bianchu, I swear. This is going to be important in the next class trial. Don't say that. Please, don't say that. Ooh, hello. Well, time to sell some more flamestone chips. Am I going the right way? I might not. I don't even know. Wait, no. Wait. No, I need to head back. I need to head back the other way. Okay. Let's go stop off at the Toidles. There we go. Oh, hi-o. Should I get that done for you? No worries. Wait, we can just buy these? Okay. Let's go take a look at our equipment. Oh, I already have those. Huh. I love how it looks like they're on fire. That is a lot of damage. And let's go put those on. Actually, can I enhance anything else? Cool. Can't do the ribbon. Can't do anything there. Are those all calcite fragments? No, amphibole, fluorite. Calcite, okay. Okay, we're back around. All right, cool. Kanono Island.
Scout ships.
Give me 1 second. I will be right back. All right, and we're back. Not you. There we go. All right. So we've got to go up, right? We've got to head back the way we're coming. Because we need to head back to, Shigurane? I don't remember his name. Normally, I feel like I'm, like, decent at names, but... not here. What are the two green dots on the map? What does that mean? Are those people to talk to? Ah. Oh no! They're in a room full of zombies. I don't feel bad. Here? Is this right? I'm going to assume no. We can't cross to you. Okay. Never mind. Is this just going to take us to Demon Friends? Oh, I forgot to sell the chips. RIP. This isn't just going to take us to Demon Friend's workshop, is it? This might be. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. No, okay, so from here we get to the save point, and then we go all the way down. I think last time it said... last time it stopped us from going forward. Okay. Onwards we go. Never mind. Where do I... I'm so lost. Of all things. Oh, I definitely want to have that honor. Learn speed, skill learn speed plus 10%. Wait, 25? Why would I mean, I like the way it looks, but like, why would I want that? All right, never mind. So many swords. Okay, so this clearly isn't the way we want to go. Best Shigure at the ports. Past them. I guess we're leaving. Weird. I thought that there was. I guess it makes sense. They talked about leaving. I thought there's a room. I thought there was a room we were supposed to go to. That might have been just the room to go back to the entrance. Dang. You want to use things only to unlock their abilities permanently? True, but... Slowing capability 1.12? I mean, I guess that's okay. I just feel like that's... For the damage trade-off, that's just not worth it. Like, going from, what, 117 to 25? Don't tell me I just came from here. Don't tell me I just came from here. Don't do that. Don't do that to me. Like, I still have a slight headache going on, so, like, I'm getting turned all around and using my brain too much. I just stop thinking. I just do. No more think. Only do. Uh-oh. Where's the item? Was there no item? I thought I saw a glimmer. Once you master it, they'll stay even on the 112, whatever the other one is. Right, but how long we need to use it for? 166? 133, 109. To me, it seems like it's the last thing that we would really want to try to get a spring for. Oh my gosh, we still have so much more to go. Jesus. I mean, I'm just using the 360 controller, so it'd be X. X is the square equivalent. Instead of cross or whatever, you silly PlayStation users say. I remember reading an article going over why the different, like, buttons are what they are on the PlayStation controller. And, like, why... gotta be quicker than that. If I remember right... Square was supposed to be used for menus. Triangle was supposed to be used for first person. Circle was to accept, and the cross was for cancel. I think that was like what the intended, like, face buttons were designed for. I forgot where I read that. I want to say I actually read that in an article back when I was looking up stuff about Dark Souls. I don't remember how I got there. I think I might have got there when I was looking up stuff for, like, Armored Core. Going, like, a history of FromSoft. It's been a good few months, though. I don't remember. I think in the manual, it's called Cross. Like, it was originally supposed to be called Cross. But everyone just calls it X. Because it's an X. Man, I would love to find a teleporter. Leave me alone. Okay, leave me alone and lend me your broom, man. Can have it both ways. Thank you. Circles are correct in Japan and X are incorrect. Sounds right. I mean, I remember finding it So, one of the first games I ever played, Final Fantasy VII. And circle is your accept, or like your okay button. And X is cancel. And playing games after that where X was confirm, circle was cancel felt really, really weird to me. I think it's this one. I think this is what we're looking for. Uh-oh. Sure, I guess.
We won, right?
Goodbye, Trent. See you later. Go! Okay. I never know what those tentacles are gonna do, man. Oh, right. Let's go back to...
Why, sir?
Having you be up and running. Is this gonna take us back? Where's this gonna go to? It's gonna take us to the ruins. Is that where we want to go? I don't remember. I'm gonna say yes. This is where we want to go. That's what these emojis are for, correct and incorrect. That's actually interesting. I don't know why they'd have the circle. I would think that, like, the check mark would be correct and then the X is for, I mean, just generally incorrect. To be fair, I don't know what, like, 99% of emoji are for, so there's also that. I'm getting so dizzy. No, that just has me think of the YMCA. I see the cat spirit over there. I don't want to. Well, that is certainly a shot game. Thank you for that. That's so weird. Why would this mean correct? How does that make sense? Like, that I get, like, I've watched Family Feud, right? Like, I've watched a bit of Family Feud. Like, I can get, like, that. But, like... Oh, that thing was just zoom. Zoom on. Ow, I'm sorry, I didn't mean it.
Wow, all sorts of things popped out.
Oh, hey, chest. I guess we never came down here. A life bottle. Oh, I would gladly take a life bottle. Especially after Spooter Lady. I vaguely remember coming down here. Arms crossed is incorrect. Arms and body making a circle together is correct. I still don't understand why that is. Like the X I can buy. That makes sense. Why would the other one? I don't know. Maybe that's just the me thing. I know I have difficulty understanding a lot of things very easily. Am I going back downstairs? Wait, have we been down here? Yeah, we have been down here. Yeah, we've been down here. It's just what Japan decided. I mean, okay. Who am I to say no? Yeah, we were watching the video yesterday of the Who Wrote Carmel Dansen, and I cannot get over how much I love all the Japanese emoticons. And just like the different faces they can make with characters. Love it so much. What was the site that they like referenced? Nika Nika Doki? Was it? But like, that was really interesting. Like, comments made on videos would be like displayed on the video itself. Uh oh, I did not mean to do that.
This fight is over.
Okay. Blood Moon. Blood Moon. Ooh, I like the way that sounds. I've watched one when I somehow ended up there. It was neat. I've never been on the site. Just saw like the like clips and stuff from it. Where in the hell am I going? Upper Ruins. No. I want to go to Lower Ruins. Central Ruins? What the hell? How do I leave? Oh, well, I'm going backwards. Yo, I'm so lost. My god. I have to use my brain. I'm not in the state right now to use my brain. Everything hurts. I think it's a Splatoon Let's Play entirely in Japanese. Oh my gosh. Or entirely in Japanese with mascots? Alright, when you say mascots, what do you mean? Are we talking like full like Splatoon mascots? How is this working? I guess we're gonna go back to the ravine. There's no way that I'm going the right direction here. Is there? Is there a way I haven't gone yet? Right, so this is where we start. Okay, if memory serves right, we got sent out of the Earth Source, into this ruin. And then we wound up out here. So this is where we essentially started from. So we need to head elsewhere to get to the port city. That makes sense to me. Okay. Western area? Maybe? What does this mean? I don't know where we are. We've been here. The two anime Inkling girls, their own OCs, and I think they were voicing both of them themselves. Different inflection energy in the voice act that both characters. Unfortunately, this was a couple years ago, so I probably couldn't find it if I wanted to. Leave me. Thank you. Does Splatoon even have... surely it has a story. I don't know, I only know Splatoon from, like, the multiplayer stuff. I don't know where we're going. Fishiguri at the port past the mine. The port past the mine. Does that mean that I've just like come a long ass way for no reason at all? When I should have just been holding X direction to go past the mine? Is that what happened here? Because I have this really funny feeling that might be what happened here. Oh, don't like this. So Blood Moon is the same Blood Moon from Zestiria. Interesting. It's only told in vague notes. It's not told straight to the player. Watch videos about the Splatoon lore. Just please don't tell me that there's a VOD video for Splatoon. What's up, Rourke? This game's spooky? Don't let the witch costume fool you. This game isn't spooky. It's very wholesome. Oh my god. No! Wait, I'm up top again! Wait! Wait, no! I just went in a gigantic fuck-all circle. Oh my god. Chat, can you play this game for me, please? Please? I'm going crazy. Why is this so hard? Why is walking and moving places so goddamn hard? Oh my god. Let's go here. Have we been here? Of course we've been here. Where's the stupid port city?
Let's get started!
I'll take it. Sure.
Hey, is everyone all right?
Ultimately, all of humanity is wiped out by global warming. Scientists put themselves in this canon of our nation. Time passed, and the Octopi and Squids evolved, lived in harmony until they got into wars over lack of resources. What? No. No. Squids and octopus evolved. Well, I don't know what I expected, but it certainly wasn't that for the lore. Alright, capability versus armored crustaceans. I feel like I want to go with that. Probably end up using that. Okay, cool. Woo, new weapon! Ooh, ship returned.
Scout ships.
Okay. I'm going this way. Can I head to the left? No, not really. So how do I get below? So the answer to the question, Squidder Kid, is definitely squids. Ooh. But we can't cross! Oh my god. How does this do? That's not it, is it? Right by the... Please don't tell me that's it. Please, game, don't tell me that there is, like, some way, some entrance, some opening right by the tunnel. Is there a direction from the tunnel that I need to go through? No. Okay, it's not. Okay. Do I need to go through the tunnel? It's at the port past the mine. I'm so tired of seeing this place. I swear. I don't like that my old dummy head, like, literally cannot keep track of where I'm going. So we just head off to the left here? There's more Splatoon lore, but that's the basics of it. Is there a Splatoon, like, economy? Because, I mean, we got, like, multiple cities, right? What if I want to try to head off, off to the right. Instead. Like, instead of going through the... to the mine depths, we just head to the right? Is that going to take us out? Oh, I sure hope so. Okay, well, we haven't been here before, it looks like, so this is new. New is good. New means progress. We need to go light a fire. How do I go light a fire? Let me go light a fire real quick. Is that it? Just the one? A cat's chest? Rip item. I mean, almost certainly Inklings like to make a fashion statement. You can work a shady job as Splatoon 2, harvesting Salmonoid eggs.
Why did he call your storm howl a reject?
What are Salmonoids?
Well, you see, when blacksmiths
I'm gonna regret
make
asking
swords,
that.
They don't just make one at a time. They make a whole bunch. The best one of them all is the one that gets presented to the sword's commissioner, while the rest are tossed aside.
Huh. I didn't realize the standards were so high.
The head of my clan gets the real Storm Howl, and his siblings get the remainders.
Oh. So one is real, and the others are imitations?
I guess so. Shigure has the real one, and... yeah, guess that makes mine an imitation.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to imply...
Don't apologize. You got me to finally realize something. It might just be why I'm so hung up on beating him.
Oh. And to Velvet? Which Lafayette is real, and which is the imitation?
Oh my
what are you
god.
Saying? She means my name. It's the same as Velvet's brother's.
The one who went and got sacrificed by Artorias.
Surely you are mistaken. Our shepherd would never do such
Eleanor,
a thing.
You
but
thick,
what else could make Velvet
dumb
hate Artorias so much?
I swear to
so
God.
You have a truth?
Use your tiny fragment
which is the real
of a brain,
and which is the imitation?
Please. Please. I feel like Elnor has a fucking, imitation brain at this point. Jesus Christ. Basically, bipedal salmon, less advanced than Inklings and Octolings. They seem to have a trade agreement or alliance with the Octoling. What in the world? Although, I mean, I can't say shit. Like, this kind of reminds me of, something I would find in Legend of Mana. So, I can fuck with it. Come on, where's my flame at? Okay. I guess we can go through here. Is that it? This is evidenced by their chiefs piloting giant robots. I think you're gonna have to forgive me when I ask, what the fuck? So Splatoons is also a mecha game? What? Why? For what purpose? Why?
You and Shigure both use the Rangetsu style. But to me, it looked like you both fight completely differently. Why is that?
Our school encompasses two distinct forms. To the outside world, we're known for fighting with a single great sword. But we also study dual short swords should need arise.
So, Shigure uses the great sword, and you use the short.
In most schools, wouldn't the secondary technique be used primarily in support of the first?
That's true for us as well. We learn the dual short swords to provide sparring partners for those studying the great sword.
Then why would you handicap yourself against Lord Shigure? He's no mere swordsman.
As I'm painfully aware, Shigure is a true master. We trained together since we were small children. I was his sparring partner for 10 years. His skill with the great sword is godlike. So, in order to beat him, I took up the short blades. To our school, it might be secondary, but it's what I know best.
You're badly disadvantaged in reach.
If I eliminate my fear, I have a chance.
That's the ticket.
If I can control the terror of being split in half and I can step inside his guard, he'll have 2 times the trouble.
Eliminating fear, huh? A style for someone who's lost his humanity.
Right?
It's like you two brothers are the very swords you carry.
Huh?
Storm Howl, a godlike sword known to all as the strongest there ever was. Storm Quell, burdened by the ceaseless struggle to best the other. One, an exorcist who walks in the light. One, a demon moving through the shadows. The only thing these two polar opposites want
is to cut down the other.
Precisely!
Both are renowned blades. But I don't see what exorcists and demons have to do with it.
Huh. Anything over here? No? Ooh. Story mode has the hero facing down the Octopi forces, which come in essentially two different species. One less mobile and more reliant on tech, the other practically a carbon copy of the Inklings but under mind control. Oh. Well, I was worried. But then he said mind control. And I feel a lot better now. That's okay. Sounds wild. I wonder how many people play Splatoon just for the story. Like, there's no way that someone puts down, like, puts in Splatoon into their console and is like, man, I can't wait for the big reveal of the story. Instead of, man, I can't wait to pwn some kids in Splatoon. I feel like that just doesn't happen. Oh wow, we are like right here. Poor Cadnex, okay. I didn't think like the mine would like connect directly to the town. What a Norman hat. What a Norman suit. Oh no. This is terrible. It's actually terrible. Can I get up on top of? No, I can't. I can't use a halo. Oh no. Where do I want it? Well, rip Halo. I'm sorry. Use them as a leader and walk for a bit. Oh no. Yeah, that's a compass. Yeah, stuff your nose full of that compass. You sniff it good.
Why does this exist? Why does this exist?
Ribbon that helps, it's where I remain calm and focused. A ribbon, you say? Ooh, shit. Oh, our stats go way down. Take a nap and everyone just ups and vanishes. What could have happened? I don't know, my guy. Wait, but I just bought shit. Nah, I'm not dealing with it. I do not care enough. Alright, let's head out to port. I should probably save. I probably should. Oh well.
There they are.
Which must mean they took out every one of the exorcists who went after them.
Hey, I told them not to bother. Now, how did that sword of yours turn out? Fine. I'll find out myself.
Okay. Well, here we go. We're gonna die.
Rokuro, we can handle the exorcists. Go and find your victory.
Thanks, Norman.
All right, let's get down to business.
Two defeats.
Not bad. Better not die too quickly on me. I want this to be fun. Come on, bro. Don't hold back.
Shut up. Don't play games with me.
Cuts it improved.
Ow. Hey, thank you for that. Appreciate it. Okay. I really wanted to try to get the Mystic Art in there because I wanted the damage from the fuck. I'm sorry. Ow. I really wanted the damage from the focus. No, not the focus, the stun. That's what I'm looking for. All right, or just kill me before I can move. Cool. That's fine. I'll take that too, sure. Let's go. I don't want to use any more of those. The fuck? Okay. That doesn't feel right. Versus Magi. Did I 1100? Oh my god. Oh, and I'm paralyzed. Love it. Love it. Ow! My god!
Not bad at all, but I'm not done yet!
Wait, what? That's it?
You put up a good fight, I'll give you that. But you're a frickin' demon. Shouldn't you bring more to the table than pretty damn good Rangetsu style?
We won?
You don't have what it takes to win against the rightful heir.
Don't count me out. Just yet. I've got something to show you!
Oh!
Take this! What?
Jesus. Goodbye, hand.
Now that was clever. Giving up one of your own hands to go for my neck. If I was just a second slower, I'd be dead now. I like it. This is what I've been looking for.
His voice sounds so familiar.
All right. Let's call it good here. Listen up. If y'all want any hope of beating me, come find me once you're more skilled and better armed.
I'll cut you down. No matter how many times I lose. No matter how many years it takes.
And the armor's just chilling here.
There we go. That's the face I'm looking for. So vicious. It's perfect.
What is wrong with him?
Shouldn't you be worrying more about your own skin? The entire Abbey knows by now that you're a traitor.
Oh my god.
That guy, he was really strong.
Yeah, he was. They all are.
I cannot take Luffy seriously.
We'll beat him if we must. No matter what it takes.
Von Eltius here.
Let's get going.
Please, take me with you.
Yeah?
I'll make a sword that surpasses Stormhowl yet. I know I will. But for another blade to beat Stormhowl, its wielder must be a swordsman of unmatched skill.
Count me in.
Hey, Aizen. Got any room on this pile of wood scrap for a suit of armor?
If not, make someone wear it.
Works for me. You heard him, Kurogane.
Many thanks.
Okay.
It's confusing. What? Oh god. Shirane?
Right,
Kurogane?
Yeah. We're headed for the Isolde Archipelago in South Gand.
This is so screwed up. Ooh. Okay, cool. We can swap out you for you. We lose a few bits of stat. Okay, that's fine.
Velvet's demon hand. It's such a mysterious weapon. I can only imagine how much of a threat it will become to the Abbey. This calls for a clear-headed breakdown of everything I know about it so far. It changes shape in a flash, and could devour most anything. How must that feel, to devour something with your hand like that? But it doesn't devour the bandages that cover it up. Maybe they're protected with some sort of special art? Likewise, the rest of her outfit can't be ignored. One would think she wouldn't want to wear such ragged clothing, yet she clearly has no inclination of buying something new. I suppose that could be taken to mean she has some sort of attachment to it. But that top is really big for her. Like it was made for a man! Maybe she wears that outfit in memory of someone important to her. I'd better not touch it then. I know I may not look it, but I really am good at sewing. Maybe I should suggest mending her clothes rather than outright replacing them. On the other hand, That fabric looks like it would be hard to push a needle through. I could be in over my head. But the tougher the fight, the more I get fired up! Of course, Lord Artorias would probably scold me if he heard me talking like that.
Who'd scold you for what now?
Oh, well, I was thinking about sewing! I mean, your clothes, they're all beat up, and I thought that if I offered to mend them for you, you'd probably scold me, wouldn't you?
You'd mend my clothes? Have they been worrying you that much?
I mean, not like constantly or anything. It just crosses my mind from time to time.
Are you good at it?
Yes. I'm told I come across as awkward sometimes, but if nothing else, I'm good with my hands.
I see.
It's very much me.
All right. If I ever need it done, I'll come to you.
Good. Just leave it to me.
Are you feeling all right? You're really sweating. The heat and the cold doesn't bother me at all. But you're a human, so you need to take care of yourself. And if you keep soaking in your own sweat, you'll catch a cold. Besides, I don't imagine it feels that great. You should keep washing and bathing on your own schedule, like however you did before falling in with us. Just let me know and I'll make it work. Because the guys aren't considerate enough to stop and ask you if you need to.
Sure. All right. Thanks. That was a surprisingly normal thing for her to say.
I was just about to say.
I probably shouldn't bother with her clothes for now. We girls have to be considerate of each other.
Okay. That is something to say, I suppose. Alright, we're sailing off to Grimoire? No, we're sailing off to Isolde to meet Grimoire.
So, you guys made it. Whatever happened to that swordbreaker?
He's been dealt with.
Oh, it's bandits!
What are you doing here?
After everything you said to me, I had a change of heart. I quit banditry.
Reformed bandit.
I'm glad you listened to reason. What do you plan on doing from here on out?
I'm heading to the capital. I plan on opening a restaurant for bandit cuisine.
Bandit cuisine?
Yeah. You get your hands on all sorts of food as a bandit. You gotta use what you have, and still make a tasty meal. Like a wild mushroom omelet minus the eggs. Or highwayman stew. It's like a hunter's stew, but, you know, made by bandits.
That sounds somewhat improper, actually. But I'd still love to visit after you open.
Really? All right. I'll be an upright citizen in no time. Maybe even the kind of man you'd consider spending some time with.
I'm rooting for you.
Hey, were you actually listening to him?
Of course I was. It's wonderful he's turned over a new leaf.
Same. Yeah, this is certainly something. I'm not sure quite what it is, but it is certainly something. Oh, that's where we came from. Okay, so this place is pretty small. Got it.
Hey, you there. That's one impressive sword you got.
I'm tiny.
You know a lot about swords?
I'm a novice swordsmith. Been at it for 20 years. Now, I'm finally able to make a blade worthy of the name.
20 years? And still just a novice?
It's a competitive world out there for a swordsmith. Especially here on this island.
But I heard many swordsmiths have given up. There's less ore around nowadays, and swords don't work against the demons.
True, swords are useless against demons. Unless it's an exorcist that's using them. Kednik's weaponry has always been prized in Midgant. The Abbey recognized our talents, and now, business is booming. All the smiths here are grateful to the Abbey. They're keeping all of us alive and fed.
Interesting. I've just seen the tail just wiggle. It's so funny. Oh, hello. Chimbaloon 2. Alright, we have 640. That is Danger Jr. Need 2K. What is the void, Norman? Okay. Actually, go ahead and take those. Only cost one. Why is stuff so dang expensive? Worth it.
Aizen, I thought you were supposed to be in Midgand. How did you end up here in Eilgand? I thought I'd gotten used to you performing the impossible, but this time, I'm at a loss for words. We heard from the Bloodwings that the Abbey might have taken you guys out.
Not this time, but our luck won't last forever. Think of this as a dry run for when I really kick the bucket.
Aye, aye, first mate. More importantly, are you sure it's okay to bring an exorcist aboard?
I've got my eye on her. If she does anything funny, I'll handle it.
Got it. We'll be on our guard, too.
We'll be on our guard, too. I love how they talk. Oh my gosh.
Take a look at this.
Oh, we brought back potatoes. True winner is us.
Scout ship setting.
Hi, Ben Mike. Why in blazes would it be Eilgand? Skipper's curse, of course. Continents are connected by sea routes. When you wish to travel to a different continent, talk to Benwick at the port to ride the Van Eltia. Traveling in this manner doesn't cost gold, making it an excellent option for travel. And we want to set to Yisold.
I gotta say, you guys look less like pirates and more like a circus troupe.
Oh, don't tell Luffy that.
Having demons on board, Benwick?
That's rude.
Not remotely.
It's not his fault he's wearing his outfit.
If you're aboard this ship of misfits, you're a pirate. That's just our creed. At least, that's what the captain and the first mate always say.
Speaking of the captain, what's Eifried like?
Let's see. How do I put it? He's like if the sea were a person, and that person had a pointy beard.
A bearded sea?
Look, everybody on this ship is an outcast from society in some way. Despite that, Captain Eifried accepted us for who we are, and took us all on board.
So he's a kind man.
Well, would you say that the sea is kind? How would it feel to dive in with an open wound?
It would sting.
I was mentioning Luffy.
Quite so.
It's funny.
Some days he's calm and steady, and others he rages. He can be shallow, deep, even a whirlpool.
How does one just become a whirlpool? What does
that
even mean?
Like he's a little scary and hard to read.
Yeah. Sometimes it's hard to serve him, but that air of mystery keeps us around and makes us want to take those jumps. At the end of the day, the Dread Pirate Van Eifried is one hell of a guy.
He sounds like Velvet in a lot of ways.
Wait, what? How so? I didn't describe him right at all, did I?
Benwick, we're changing course at once for Port Renied.
Sir? What's going on?
Three of our men have collapsed from the Corsair Scourge. They first showed symptoms 3 days ago. How are you holding up?
I'm still doing all right. But if this really started 3 days ago, that means we're all carrying it, doesn't it?
That's what I'm afraid of. But if we head straight to Port Renied, we should be able to get medicine there.
I'll check on everyone's condition.
Make sure everyone stays hydrated, including yourself. Understand?
Sir, yes, sir. All hands, assume emergency positions.
The crew's holding up well for a bunch of folks at Death's Door.
Mm-hmm. What do you mean? Is this Corsair Scourge fatal?
Quite. No one knows what causes it, but it starts with a high fever and ends up with the body falling apart like sand.
Oh!
Like sand?
Great!
Once, there was a great band of pirates who ruled the seas, but the disease spread through their ships and killed every one of them. That's why it's called the Corsair Scourge. Does that mean we've been infected as well?
You humans, for sure.
Only humans fall prey to the Corsair Scourge.
Then it could have gotten to you too. Right, Moggy Lou?
Oh, right! Alas! That my glorious saga should meet such an ignominious end!
I can't allow our vessel to die from this. If you start to feel ill, speak up.
I will.
All right. We'll all be helping out in the search. Everyone but Eleanor, that is.
Huh? Oh, why does she get to stay? I might be dying too, you know!
You're a witch. Magic yourself healthy. Now quit whining and get going.
Oh, not even a witch is safe from the ravages of the Reaper's Curse!
Or Magalu.
The Reaper's Curse?
That's not the continent I thought we were going to. Of course it's raining. Oh, is this,
okay, where's the herbalist?
Well, it starts with a Z.
If I remember right, the Corsair's Scourge needs a particularly special medicine.
Yeah, it's a wildflower called Salatoma.
Salatoma.
Its juice can cure the Corsair's Scourge.
Well, doesn't sound too tricky.
Let's not relax until we have it in hand.
Right. Now let's get going.
Hold on a minute. Won't you just be spreading the disease if everyone wanders into town?
Surprisingly, no. For whatever reason, you can only catch it over the ocean waves.
Well, that's
it's speculated
convenient.
It might have something to do with the salt in the air, or maybe the microbes in the seawater.
Nobody knows the cause for sure, but there are no recorded cases of people catching it on land.
I see. A strange affliction indeed.
We'll be back soon. You all remain on the ship.
All right. Good luck out there, sir.
We've got to hurry.
Salatoma, is this really going to be necessary?
What do you mean, Eleanor?
Oh, nothing. It's just, well, the herb is known to work well for fevers and the like, but it tastes bad. So bad. Some say it would even bring a demon to the brink of tears.
Maybe so. But better to drink it than to die, right?
That's right.
I'm not worried. It just reminded me of stories from my childhood, is all.
What stories? Or I guess rather, why? I think she was immediately worried, not because she's ditzy, I think maybe she's not entirely human. I mean, she does have elf ears, though.
The map's getting filled in little by little.
There's still a long way to go. It's a big world out there.
Yeah, like, even without the, like, cosmetic item, like, she still has, like, very pointed ears.
Far seas are unexplored territory for a reason.
I'd imagine so. The seasons and the weather can change the sea completely.
Oh. Do I sense a budding interest in the sea?
Think you're feeling less apathetic about it now?
I wouldn't say that. I was just reminded of something someone once said to me.
That Rokuro, always telling all of us except Eleanor to work harder. Doesn't he realize that I'm a delicate maiden too? This is workplace discrimination. I should put him on a witch trial and burn him at the stake.
You're preaching to my soul,
Magalu. Work.
What's wrong, Eleanor? You look like you've got something on your mind.
I'm just trying to figure out what Rokuro was thinking when I had Lord Shigure at the end of my spear. Rokuro threw his dagger right at my head. I thought I was dead for sure. I feel like I saw who he truly was, and it frightens me. But he and Lord Shigure are always trying to kill each other. I can't understand why he did what he did.
It might have something to do with his Bushido code.
What's Bushido? Is that like a sword fighter's code?
It's a way of thinking. Be loyal to your lord. Respect your parents. Protect the weak. And act with honor.
You're saying that he was following this Bushido code, and he was protecting me because I was weak?
He might have turned into a demon, but his memories and personality are still intact. I doubt his moral values have disappeared either.
Do you really can't remember seeing anyone else with those ears.
Yeah, they definitely seem unique to her. Shazam!
That's the true nature of a Rangetsu man. I heard that when Velvet first met him, he immediately attacked her without any provocation. I'm sure you haven't already forgotten how he turned his swords on the kid in that fight against Kurogane.
I wouldn't read too much into what Magilu's saying. Rokuro lives for his sword, and that's just who he is. But I don't think he's all that bad. I thought you were the one who called him frightening.
I know I said he can be a scary person, but how do I put it? I do feel there's more to him than just wanting to cut people up.
Aww. Look at her learning.
He's more sensitive to other people's emotions than he might seem to be at first glance. A sword fighter has to sense his opponents on some level, right?
For a crazed demon, he's actually a nice guy. Is that it?
Maybe. I don't know. It's not like I know him well enough to claim any deep personal insight or anything.
You brought it up.
I mean, I still support the... Oh, what was it? The Rokuro Aizen ship? But Rokuro Elnor? Last character is one in the village. Here in Westkin, plants and animals infected with demon body have been attacking folks, so the apothecary barely has time to sleep.
A bit ago, a manacled body got caught in my nets.
Manacled? A prisoner?
You too? Yesterday, my nets pulled up an arm. Manacles, even a brand on that one.
I really can't take this anymore. I'm losing my appetite, and it's bad for my heart.
You said it. Judging by the tides, they would have to have come from that prison island. Is it really just a prison?
You think it's strange, too?
Okay.
I've suspected something about that place for a while now. They say the whole island is a prison. But if you ask me, I bet it's just an execution ground.
Or it's for experimenting on demons.
Experimenting? What do you mean?
Testing the demons' capabilities. That's why they need prisoners. Food for the monsters.
Not a bad theory.
Just kidding! There's no way the Abbey would do something that horrible, right?
Yeah, you're right.
You sure think of some crazy ideas. I bet all of this is the work of some vicious pirate gang.
Yeah, something like that.
That guy, he's pretty sharp.
Now that you mention it, I haven't seen any patrol ships around there recently. Used to be they'd chase you off if you got too close.
You know, you're right. If there are pirates about, it'll mean trouble unless the Abbey tightens up their patrols.
The best we can do is keep a wide berth of it for now. We wouldn't want pirates and demons sneaking up on us.
I think we'd notice if pirates or demons were around. No way they'd catch us unawares.
I can't tell if he's sharp or dull as a brick.
Same. I'm very confused. Do you have anything new? No. No. Okay. I guess let's go forward. Oh. So we're going to like town proper. Okay.
That's an interesting bridge.
This bridge has a bit of history to it. Port Renied was originally built here on this inlet. The water's deep enough for ships, but as you can see, it's a bit too narrow for a port. Large ships couldn't come close without a top-rate crew. So Port Renied was used almost exclusively by smaller ships.
What about the Von Eltia?
We're the best of the best. We came and went as we pleased.
So your point is you wanted to brag.
Hey, let me finish. The people wanted their town to grow. So they built an outer harbor for large ships and this bridge to connect to it.
Uh-huh. So that's why the port and the town are separate.
But there's more. We secretly help provide the funds and resources for them to build it.
So you are bragging.
And did this bridge bring prosperity to Port Renied?
No. The Abbey began regulating shipping and travel, right about the time the town finished building the outer port. If only the seas had remained free, Port Renied would have developed into a center for commerce and trade.
I suppose things don't always go as planned.
Then again, even if Port Renied became a bustling port, we still would have no trouble slipping in or out.
I'm not biting this time.
Alright, let's go stop on in, shall we? Go introduce ourselves to the locals. Hey, what's... Did I hear a frog? I heard a frog. Come, let us squeak together, my friends. No? Alright. Locals we go.
When I was in Port Zexen, I heard
Zexen,
that a swarm of demons attacked the palace and killed the high priest.
No way! Isn't the palace the most heavily guarded place in the world? How did the exorcist let that happen?
Bad news really does travel fast.
They say that the demons were disguised as humans, but were actually enormous monsters twice the size of any man. They had razor-sharp horns and three burning eyes. They could take over your mind just by glaring at you.
I guess that helps our cover.
The demons were that terrible. No wonder the exorcist couldn't deal with them.
Some rumors say they escaped. Some say a legate took them down in a climactic battle. But no one knows the truth. We should be ready to run in case they show up.
Is the world falling apart? Will the bad times return again?
Will the bad times return?
Three eyes, huh? Velvet, you're one scary lady.
They said swarm. So they were talking about you, too.
Thank you. Don't mind me.
I know I'm repeating myself, but that's just not possible.
But the High Priest hasn't been seen since then. How do you explain that? I heard some people from the capital say that he might have been attacked by demons.
The Abbey's trying to cover it up, but the truth is getting out.
The security at the palace is better than anywhere else. Demons breaking in? Inconceivable.
But what if a whole horde assailed the castle?
The exorcists guarding the palace are elite. The best of the best. Horde or not, they couldn't have gotten in.
But what if they were some sort of giant demons? No matter how elite the guards may be, they'd have trouble against something like that.
If giant demons appeared in the capital, there'd be an uproar. I understand your concerns. But please remain calm and trust us. Panic and confusion is just what the demons want. They'll use it to slip into this very town.
Well, we know that, but still.
It looks like rumors from the capital are spreading.
I think that's us.
The more chaos there
is, I think we're in town.
The easier it'll be for us to move around.
Hello, chest. Don't give us the panacea bottle. Give us the life bottle. Oh, how in the world do I get that? Oh. Easily. Cool. Alright. Fire attack power. I'm considering it. I don't think it will, but I'm certainly considering it. Oh, I can't grab it? How do I get back there? Okay. I guess that makes sense. I'm Hidemi, third son and rising star of the character card family. Allow me to test your talent for the game. The goal of this game is to claim matching pairs of cards to collect scoring sets. Begin each turn by choosing one card from your hand and playing it on the field. The card with the matching title is currently on the field and may take both cards into your scoring pile. If there's no match, your card remains on the field. Draw a card from the deck, place it on the field, and resolve as above. Each card belongs to a scoring set indicated by an icon on the lower right of the card. Scoring sets are formed once you collect a certain number of cards belonging to that set. Your number of currently claimed cards of each set is displayed on the screen's right. Once you've completed a scoring set, you may end the round and collect points for your sets. So you can play multiple cards to get the sets. You may also opt to continue the round, but you won't be able to end the round to collect points until you've completed another set. Continuing allows you to reach for higher scores, but risks your opponents completing a set first and opting to end the round in their favor. The winner is the player with the most points at the end of three rounds. The winner will be rewarded with Tails coins with higher scores or any more coins. Same? Yeah, same rewards. Okay. How the hell does this work? Oh my god, how many characters are there? Oh, these are like all different characters of the series. Huh. So, what, manage the icons on the left? But I didn't do... what? Okay. I should probably play you to get... Well, I can't play you because I don't get all four, right? I just get the two? What does the bottom left mean? Is that the scoring? No! That's fine, because I can still use you. Otherwise, I'm pretty much... Oh, this is still round one. Oh, dang. The background matches if they're from the same game. You only match characters from the same game. The bottom right corner of the card is the type of points you'd earn. Gotcha, and I don't know, like, what the type of points correspond to. Hold on a second. Sorry about that. Whew. All right. What did I miss? Right. I look to the right to see the score. Right. I see that. I see the different colors, the numbers. We got the 3, 2, 2, 7. Should get lots of a particular type or bunches of multiple types, or get lucky and collect all the cards from a game. Okay. Soccer Fly Friends and Life Prize 2 to get enough. To the Sakura. I'm looking for the Sakura. Sakura's the third one down, right? On the left-hand side. So I've got one, I've got zero. I see that our squiggly arrow is two and it's golden. I don't have anything I can actually play. No! Well, I don't like that, because we're probably going to get... Oh, whoa. Can you help? This is everything we've read before, isn't it? Oh. Oh! Oh. So how that work? Is it 4, 6, 12, 14, 10, well, 5, 7, 8, 16? Are we in a lead? Holy. Never mind. Fuck. What? How do you, like, determine how? I mean, how do you determine if you can end the round or not, though? I don't like that I have all three of these. Rough. Well, there's no way. When you score, you get to decide. How do you score? Is it collecting all pair? Is that in here? So in order to score, you need all of this. Oh yeah, God, this is so much. Oh God, this is so much. Can I just give up? I just want to give up. I have no fucking idea what's going on. Didn't know that was there. Just learn the rules on your own. I commend anyone who can learn this on their own. And I could take that, because if we take that, like, they don't get the... We're all princesses, right? Although I could have kept that up, but okay. It's the only one we can do. I'm getting fucking played! My God! No, I didn't mean to do that. I meant to finish. I meant to finish. I meant to finish. Shit. Shit. Oh, well. One second. Yeah, I realize. I just wanted to be over. Oops. Normal. Wait. What the fuck just happened? And how did I win? What? No, I don't want to try again. Fuck that. I think that's the only time I'll ever play that, and I will revel my completely earned and justified winnings. cool. Why that happened, I don't know. But I'm a god, I guess. I didn't realize it worked that way. Worked what? I don't even know what happens. I assume because, like, I went to go... What? I went to accidentally press continue the round. I wanted it to be over. I played a card. I don't think it matched anything. And then the card after, it picked up something and that finished a set? So that's quite, convenient.
Take a look at
our first three win, man, back to back to back to back wins.
This recipe looks real tasty.
Cool.
Scout.
Apparently when you score and you end the round, they don't get the points for their scoring sets. Oh yeah, that makes sense, because it's only based on what you did, because it's your turn playing.
Hello there. How can I help you today?
We're looking for Salatoma flowers.
Otherwise, like, I had sets in the previous few rounds, but I didn't get them because I was the one who ended the round.
The very same. Some of our crew developed fever 3 days ago. I want to take care of it as quickly as possible.
Understandable, but unfortunately, I'm out of stock right now.
Of course, I'm out of stock right now.
Out of stock. The flower's in season, isn't it?
It is, but not too long ago, a demon appeared in Warg Forest where we harvested. And now the Abbey won't let anyone inside.
They what? Why haven't they exterminated the demon?
From what little I've heard, they've had trouble tracking the thing. 100 people go in, maybe only one will actually come across the beast.
If it's so rare, then what's the danger?
Because nobody who's encountered it has come back alive.
First the Corsair Scourge.
How do you know that?
Medicine, the Abbey, and a mysterious demon. Never a dull moment with the Reaper's Curse, eh?
I could try to order some from other towns, but if you're already on day 3, they might not make it in time.
But if we go to the Warg Forest... The Salatoma will be in bloom, correct?
Right, but the demon...
We're going to the forest.
We're going to the forest, alright. To the forest we go. Just playing very defensively, so I didn't get to see that side of the game. How do you play defensively? I feel like you need to play aggressively. Ah! Alright, bull friends. With that said... We've been streaming for a good little while. I'm starting to get, like, just really lightheaded. We finished our card game. We got more story stuff. We'll pick up, we'll pick up tomorrow with some more Berseria. Get through, well, we gotta go find out the demon. Get the herbs for Mr. Apothecary person. Yeah, we'll get all that done tomorrow. I've had a fantastic time seeing you guys tonight. It's been a good one. And, I don't know. I'll see y'all tomorrow. See y'all tomorrow. Enjoy the rest of your night, everyone. And then, of course, just as a reminder, we always have our Sunday D&D, starting around 7 p.m. Central Time. I've got to check back with them, and I believe we're still good for this Sunday. So that'd be something really exciting to get there.